I am S.A. Hingonekar from KC Engineering College, Jalgaon. So we have got remote center since last 6 years. So we'll start with the syllabus directly. So the syllabus is common everywhere. It consists of 4 units. It consists of basic concepts about the C programming. There are no written examination in our university for this subject. So the intake for the students, that is in the second year computer, it is 90. So there are the 2 classrooms, 45 each. So there are the 2 teachers who teach the subject for class 1 and class 2. So in a week there are 2 hours, and for practicals 2 hours per week per batch, and batch will be of size of 15 students. Evaluation is done on the basis of external examiner, which is appointed by the university. So he conducts the viva of 25 marks, and he asks to write the program based on the syllabus which is mentioned above. And if the program runs successfully, so he will award out of 25. Then apart from this, that is total 50 marks is in the hand of external examiner, and the 25 marks, remaining 25 marks are in the hands of the internal examiner. So generally in every week they have to conduct the program which is given to them, which is being taught in the class, and they have to perform the one program. If one program is executed, then they are asked to do the second program, and if the score of the program is more, so he will award the good number of marks as the internal marks. And if he is absent, then his absentee mark is being noted and it is being converted in terms of marks. So 5 marks are given for each practical, for each attendance. We have got 30 computers in the lab, and there are the 3 teachers who takes the lab. The 2 teachers from the classes who take the classes, and 1 additional teacher is there who takes the lab.
Can you just go back to the units that you mentioned, the syllabus? So this is for the entire North Maharashtra University?
Yes, it is for entire.
And you do not teach computer programming to all branches of engineering?
We teach to all the students, but it is being given complete knowledge to the computer students. So there are some parts of the electronic students are there.
No, what about mechanical engineers?
So we don't have a mechanical branch. We have only computer.
You may not have branch, but yes. Does the course, this particular subject,
yes.
Is it taught to all branches of engineering or not?
I don't have idea about this. I will check that.
Because everywhere else, if I understand correctly, computer programming is a compulsory subject for all branches of engineering.
Yes.
Independent of where you get admitted.
Yes.
If it is so, for example, in your case, you have what you call computer science, you also have electronics.
Yes.
So the same subject is taught to electronics or not? That will tell us whether it is common or not.
Some topics are common, up to pointers, before pointers they are taught. And they have got software engineering where electronic students. In that they learn the PSPICE software. And
the second question is, you mentioned that this course is taught in the second year.
In the second year.
Not in the first year.
Not in the first year.
So first year there is no programming course in the North Maharashtra University.
No, there is only introduction to computers.
Okay, what is taught in that?
In that, basic concept of what is hardware, what do you mean by computer, what are the different parts of the computers.
But that looks like school syllabus to me.
Yes. Just introduction is given to what is C in the first year.
So who teaches the first year course? Your department?
Our department teaches.
They don't have a laboratory or anything like that for that course?
For the first year. Yes, there is a laboratory.
So they must also be writing programs like this?
Yes.
We would be more interested in knowing the first course in programming. So apparently this is not the first course in programming that students do. This becomes the second course then.
Yes.
What would be the overlap in the first course? Because this second course itself appears to be the first course to me.
Yes, yes.
If you see the contents that yes. other colleagues have explained,
yes, yes,
this
yes.
looks very much like the first course.
Yes, yes. In the second course, they have got C++ and Java. So this is computer programming first,
huh.
and in the computer programming second, there is C++ and Java is there.
Oh, so your computer programming 1 and 2, the second one is Java,
yeah.
and before that you have an introductory course for all
first year students.
That is also a lab course, no written examination.
No written examination, just internal assessments is there.
Okay.
Of 25 marks.
And external examination like this itself.
Yes, it is there.
But there also they will be writing programs then. That you perhaps are not aware. Can you do me a favor?
Yes, sir.
Can you call up somebody in your college?
Yes.
And even by tomorrow, if you can share that information with us, it will be useful, I think, to
okay.
know. Because yours then would be a representative of a university
where yes.
the course syllabus is perhaps very primitive or very limited for the first course.
Yes, yes.
Taught to the general branches.
Yes.
Okay, anyway. What is the computing environment that you have? Do you use Linux or Windows or what?
We have got both Windows and Linux.
So you have a dual boot
system is there.
And what server do you have?
What?
Which servers do you have?
We have got
Windows, what operating system there are?
Windows servers are there.
Windows servers are
yes.
there.
There are two servers.
But if necessary, you can install Linux
yes,
as
yes,
a server and NFS mount it on
yes, the… Yes, we have installed already Linux. We have got a Linux lab separately and we have mounted on the Windows server also.
Fair enough. Thank you.